Hi there. It's Professor Monte. Let's learn how to write equations if we're given the solutions. Okay, so the basic idea is we're just going to go backwards. What do I mean by that? Well, let's see some examples and I'll show you. So think we have a problem. It says find a quadratic equation with the given solutions. And the first one, the solutions are negative 6 and 5 thirds. So essentially what that meant was x was negative 6 and x was 5 thirds. Well, where did that come from? Well, if I add 6 to both sides, I had to have had x plus 6 equals 0 as one of my factors. And over here to get the factor, let's get x equals 5 thirds. Let's multiply both sides by 3. We get 3x equals 5. Subtract the 5. We must have had 3x minus 5 equals 0. That was my other factor. Well, where'd those come from? Well, those must have been multiplied together. X plus 6 times 3x minus 5 had to be 0. I'm just going to multiply that, combine like terms, and I'm done. So let's see. We'll FOIL this out. I get 3x squared minus 5x plus 18x minus 30 equals 0. Combine these like terms. I get 3x squared plus 13x minus 30 equals 0. And that was my original quadratic equation. We can work this out. We can factor it this way to get our answer if we were to check it. But that's the idea. Now, when we're given complex numbers, we can do the same thing. We can do something like say, oh, it's x minus 4 minus 2i, and then multiply that by x minus 4 plus 2i, and multiply those out, man, that's a horrible way to do it. There's a much simpler way to do it when you have complex numbers. And the idea is, take either one of them. It doesn't matter. They're going to work out the same way. And say, let's say, okay, if x equals 4 minus 2i, and what I want to do is I want to get the imaginary part all by itself. So I'm going to subtract 4. So I've got x minus 4 equals negative 2i. And then to get rid of the I, I'm going to square both sides. And notice it didn't matter which one of these we used, because it's either going to be negative 2i squared or it's going to be positive 2i squared. Either way, the square gets rid of the negative. They're both going to be 4i squared. So I'm going to multiply that out. Now remember, that's x minus 4 times x minus 4. If you want to FOIL that out, we'll do it real quickly. Hopefully you know this is just x squared minus 8x plus 16. But a lot of times in class, I do that and my students say, "Why, Professor Monte, where'd that negative 8x come from?" Well, it came from FOIL. I'm going to get x times x is x squared minus 4x minus 4x plus 16. FOIL. And so the minus 8x minus 4x minus 4x is the minus 8x. But I get that equals, well, on this side, I square that. I get 4i squared. But remember, I squared is a negative 1, so this whole thing is negative 4. X squared minus 8x plus 16 equals negative 4. Now I add 4 to both sides, and I am done. X squared minus 8x plus 20 equals 0. And there's my quadratic equation that would have these two solutions. Okay, I like this method much better than this method. I wouldn't want to multiply this times this. It'll simplify to this, but it'll be a lot worse. So take a hint from Professor Monte. Do it this way. It'll make your life a lot easier. But the big key, go backwards to find the equation from the solutions.